Good evening and welcome to this special session on visualization. So before we begin with the session and the topic, I'll briefly introduce myself. I'm Dr. Karishma Ahuja. I'm a PhD in Metaphysical Sciences and Counseling. I specialize in the topics of the Law of Attraction, Forgiveness Therapies, and a beautiful Hawaiian modality called Ho'oponopono. Okay? So in short, everything that I do revolves around the mind, the energy, and the vibration. And along with that, the emphasis is on you being the doer. You must remind yourself always that any kind of work you undertake, whether it's a workshop you do, whether it's a session you take, it must make you more and more get motivated to work on yourself. Because ultimately, it's all about whether you are self-driven or not. If you are self-driven, you will achieve your goal. You see, if you study the lives of successful people, most of them will very humbly tell you, we didn't have anything special. It's just that we never gave up. And because we never gave up, people never gave up on us. So this is the quality which you must also imbibe now. Even when it comes to your healing, even when it comes to changing a part of our lives, each of us today also have come with something in our mind. There is something that you want to work towards, something that can get better than what it is currently, no? Firstly, before we begin the session, let us remind ourselves, we will not give up on this issue. If it is relationships I want to work on, I am not going to give up on them. If it is health I am working on, no matter what the reports say, no matter what people tell me, I am not going to give up on my health. Similarly, if it is me working on my finances, if finances are tough, if situations at home are not very pleasant when it comes to money, if there are fights and arguments happening, still don't give up. Because this quality of persistence is really required when it comes to any kind of healing, whether it's health, finances, or relationships. Okay? With that positive attitude and energy, let's come to today's topic, which is visualization. So, to make it simple for us, let's divide the topic into three parts. Okay? The first part, let's focus on understanding what is visualization. Really, what is visualization? Because then we will know if we are doing it correctly or not. The second part, let's understand why it is important. Is there really power in visualization, or it is only because I have put it in my topic, power of visualization? Or is there really some power in this? Let us focus on that a little bit in this session. And finally, the third part of the session, let's look at some tips on how to effectively visualize. Each of us may already be doing it. A lot of us are already doing it. Some of us may have practiced and now we believe it doesn't work. Or some of us have not practiced at all because we were never excited enough to do it. Or some of us may not have heard about it. We don't know which category we are in. However, let us today open our minds to understanding the topic a little better. Because when you understand something, automatically the resources you need, you are guided towards. It's almost like, you know, you become a magnet. In the true sense, what the law of attraction says, you are born with magnetism. However, that magnetism has been covered. You need to uncover that property of magnetism. So this topic also has definitely, in my experience and in the experiences of several people who have practiced visualization, can swear by this fact that it really helps. It really helps. Okay? So, let's go to the first part of the session. What is visualization? How do we define it? Who is going to tell me in simple words? No technical language here. In simple words, what is visualization?
Okay. Eyes, okay. Which we want, or which we fear, or whatever it
Okay. In our mind. Okay. Okay. Very good. An image in your mind. Yes. What else?
Something similar. Creating an image.
Creating an image. Yes.
About what is our ultimate goal.
Okay.
Act as if it is there.
And act as if it is there. Very good.
Act as if it is coming to you.
Or act as if it is coming to you.
It's has come to us.
It already has come to us.
Though it is not there. Visualizing that it is with
me. Already with you. Very good. Very good. So clearly each of us are on the right track when it comes to visualization. Undoubtedly today we already have a lot of knowledge. However, we just need to work a little more towards application. So we know so many beautiful things about visualization. But question to ask ourselves is, how many of us practice? Each of us are sailing in the same boat. We know more than what we are practicing, right? So today also, let's not leave this opportunity to commit. Now we will practice it. After hearing this information, today only go home and practice it. And trust me, if you commit to practice, then you will start seeing results very fast. Because you see, this is one technique. Visualization is one technique which is very attractive to the subconscious mind. Why? Because the mind thinks in terms of pictures and images. Your bedroom, your drawing room, your children, your spouse, your kitchen. Was it difficult? The moment I'm saying these words, there already is an image which is created in your mind. Who's doing that for you? The brain. The brain is actually an organ which is facilitating a vibration in your body, and the brain is constantly giving you these familiar pictures which are already there within you. What we call as associations. Okay? So each of us clearly are thinking a lot, right? But that's the problem. We are thinking a lot. And because we are thinking a lot, we don't realize what is going on in our minds. Even when I'm maybe sitting for a talk like that, maybe I'm driving back home, maybe I'm watching TV, but you see, my mind is constantly replaying the past. Something or the other is always going on in my mind, which means there are already a set of images fixed inside your mind. Now, for example, your focus is on me, your attention is on me. So when I say kitchen, there's only one image. When I say bedroom, there's one image. When I say garden, there is one image in your mind, no? But while you are talking, you're eating, you're interacting, you're sleeping, you don't know how many images are coming. You don't know how many of these images are pleasant, happy ones, how many of these images are unpleasant, sad, disappointing ones. So visualization is actually, in simple words, a mental technique that uses imagination. It uses imagination to consciously experience a certain event or situation. It's a conscious direction you are giving. It is that time when you are feeding into your own mind those pictures and images that you want to experience. Why is this so different from the regular thinking we are doing? Because regular thinking, the subconscious mind is giving you thoughts. In visualization, you are giving the subconscious mind a set of images. That is the difference. Are we clear on that?
Yes.
That is why this technique is important. That is why it helps. Because while you are visualizing, until you are visualizing, you are in charge. We don't know whether we are in charge or not at night. We don't know whether it's happy or sad memories. But when you are visualizing during the day, you are in control. Because if you don't like an image, you can shift. And most importantly, you can create a strong story around your goal, something that you want to experience. You can do a lot of things to visualize appropriately. Now, let's come to an important question, which was the second part of this session. Why is it so important? Clearly, we already mentioned a few points that you are in control when you visualize, right? Your subconscious mind is getting some food for thought when you visualize. What else do you think are the real benefits? Why do you think this technique is something we must take time out to practice? You see, I will explain this, okay, in form of three words. Three words that I'm going to put on the board right now will bring out the importance of visualization. Okay? The first word is be. The second word is, any guesses? Generally, the second word is something that most of us spend most of our times doing. Do, right? To do something, most of the times we are spending doing something, no? We are constantly on the go. So be, do. Now you should be guessing the third. You've heard those three famous words, be, do and have. Be, do and have. Now let me tell you where all of us score 100%. We all score maximum marks in the have part of our goal, which is, I want money. I don't want to live like that. I want to be well. I don't want this relationship. I want somebody who respects me. I need people to support me. I'm lonely. I need company. So you see, we are somewhere already in our vibration reflecting a have all the time, whether you're consciously doing it or unconsciously doing it. This is something which is already going on in your energy and vibration. Your subconscious mind knows what you want. But is this enough to get me to experience what I want? Most of the times the answer is a no. Why? Yes, because there are some gaps which are missing. There are some steps in between which are missing. Yes, this is the starting point. The have has to do with your goal. Yes, it is very important. You must have a goal in mind. In fact, the more conscious you are of your goal, the better it is, the sooner it is that you will manifest it. That is why visualization works very effectively, because in visualization, you're always visualizing one thing very clearly. Whether it's money, then I'm visualizing money. Whether it's relationships, I'm visualizing about the happiness and fulfillment in relationships. Or it could be simply me working on my physical health. There is always something that I am feeding in terms of a picture. And that would not really be possible without having a goal in my mind. An objective, right? So yes, some of us need to fine-tune our goal setting. However, we still score really high marks here, because ask anybody, they will tell you, I want happiness, I want love, I want support, I want money, I want success. This is still something we score well on. However, we are very quick to jump on this step, which is the doing. Immediately, we have a set of things we want to do. Today also, there are so many people who come to me seeking help to find, for example, the right partners, right? How do we really use our mind and energy and vibration to attract our soulmates, our life partners? And very often, most of them use this word, I want to attract the right person in my life, the right person in my life. That's the problem. They are looking and finding the right person instead of themselves trying to become the right person. I will tell you what will happen. You will attract somebody who you think is right for you. After some time, you will hopelessly try to change that person. All the married men and women are already laughing. Yes? For those of us who have tried to change others, you will agree with me, we have hopelessly failed. It is really difficult to change somebody else. But this is what happens. you went out looking for the right person, you made the decision to go ahead and marry that person, but now there are problems. There are problems because you didn't focus on becoming that which you wanted to attract. And this is the case for every other goal in life. If I'm clear about what I want, I must work towards becoming that person. Let's take another example. If I want to become a very good, successful sportswoman, right? Let's say I want to become a tennis player, a very successful tennis player. Then what do you think will bring me the success as a tennis player? I need to have the mindset. I need to have the attitude. I need to have the skills. I need to have the belief system that a successful tennis player will have. If I don't have these qualities, I practice, but it doesn't bring me the result. It is the same as far as our other goals in life are concerned. I'm doing a lot of things, I'm taking the efforts. You see, we are doing a lot to the extent that we feel we are drained. Many of us will actually feel, I have done whatever I could. Still, I am not getting the result. Probably because we are still not one with our goal when it comes to being vibrationally one with the goal. Clearly, you want to achieve something, but you are yet not in that energy or vibrational mode to expect it to come to you. You don't believe it's going to come to you. So clearly, your belief patterns, your mindset, your attitude, your feelings, those come in the way. Why do they come in the way? Because every action you take is driven by your feeling. Go back to the times when you have taken major decisions in your life. They were emotionally driven. You took decisions based on your feelings. What if you don't feel you will be successful? What if we don't feel confident enough to put out a good plan? What if we are not confident enough of winning this project? You yourself affect your chances of winning. Because your ideas and thoughts which you conceive for the project itself are bogged down by your feelings that kuch bhi karo nahi aane wala hai haath mein. You see, there is a gap between what I want and what I am receiving. There's a big difference. And one powerful way to bridge that gap, to decrease the distance between what I want and actually experiencing that very thing that I want, is visualization. Because when you visualize, you begin to change your mindset. You begin to adopt that mindset. If I am focusing on a certain goal and focusing on having achieved that goal, you are naturally going to that very level in vibration you would have gone had you actually achieved that goal. That means you are thinking like a winner. You are feeling like a winner. The pictures in your mind are that of your goal having been accomplished. Now imagine if I'm doing this regularly. I'm regularly, consciously feeding into my mind thoughts, feelings and beliefs about what I want to manifest in my life. Automatically, your consciousness begins to expand. Automatically, your mind slowly and steadily begins to become very familiar with this goal. It's almost as if you feel you're getting very close to that goal. The example of such a person who's visualizing well is, he's always upbeat, he's high in spirits, He may not see his destination very clearly right now, but there's something within him which is driving him to keep on keeping on. That quality of a winner we discussed in the beginning, they don't give up, they keep on keeping on. You've read the book Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. How many have read the book? By now, all of us should have read that book. That book is a game plan by itself. Yeah, you read the book and read it 2 to 3 times and already your mindset would have changed. Okay, have you thought of why Napoleon Hill called it Think and Grow Rich and not Work Hard and Grow Rich? Or let's think of another name, Get Lucky and Grow Rich. Why did he write Think and Grow Rich?
The car is not important, the driver who is driving
is important. Right? So there is obviously power in thinking. Visualization is a technique that helps you exercise that power. It helps you exercise that power. You see, mind power is also like that. If you don't use it, you will lose it. Visualization is a great way for you to exercise the power of your mind and get more controlled in creating your own life. Most importantly, personally, as I started to visualize, one of the greatest benefits it taught me was I started to feel better. You see, it's all about you feeling better. If you're not feeling motivated enough to wake up in the morning, if you feel lousy during the day, you are operating from your past. You're operating from your past. That means you're completely being controlled and ruled by your mind. How do I now take charge and rule my mind instead of my mind ruling me? Give your mind some different set of thoughts and images on a daily basis, and the mind will begin to adopt this new feeding that you're doing. If you do it consistently, the mind will now take this as its new priority. Think of a child. Child is very hungry and you have not brought food. The child will pick up anything from the floor and put in the mouth. But if a child is well fed, he will not pick it up because he is full. The mind is like that. If the mind is filled with positive thoughts on a daily basis, it is not going to run after negative thoughts. It's not going to wander helplessly. Give it a direction on a daily basis. Give your mind some controlled, conscious direction towards your goals on a daily basis. And the mind will stop wandering. So all of us who complain of excessive thinking, worrying too much, right? One of the ways we will actually be able to change and shift our negative flow of thoughts is through visualization. Because when you visualize, you break the old pattern. It's almost like you have applied those brakes. Okay? So therefore, let us begin visualizing. But this is the key. Do it for a few days and leave it. You're back to square one. Continue doing it. And I'm often asked, for how long should I continue? Till you don't get your results. Till you don't get your results, continue. Once you have achieved a goal, you can maybe go on to a next goal. Right? So this is why visualization is important. Scientifically speaking, okay? Scientifically, what happens to your brain when you are visualizing? Do you know there is a mechanism within the brain called reticular activity system? When it is actually activated, which is known as the RAS, what happens is, as you are visualizing, the RAS mechanism within the brain gets activated, which means you begin to get access to resources which always existed, but you see, you never could actually notice them. They always existed, but they went unnoticed, which means as you start visualizing regularly, you actually begin to get a new set of thoughts and ideas. You start accessing information you never knew you had. For example, if I am visualizing on my health, as I am visualizing, Don't think visualization is just to make you feel good and make you attract good health. Visualization creates a platform for you to feel better. How does this happen? The moment you start visualizing, yes, you feel better. But most importantly, you also get clearer. You get clearer on what you need to do for your own health. For example, this is the exercise I want to do. This is the food I must eat. This is how much I must sleep. This is the lifestyle change I need to. Nobody is going to come and tell you, but it just happens that you just get access to that information on its own so beautifully that it's almost like you're being guided by your subconscious mind. Do this. This will help you overcome your illness. Do this. This will help you overcome your financial strain. It's almost like you are getting insights. You see, we always have access to insights, but your thoughts of how difficult your life is blocks those insights. Visualization for a few minutes on a daily basis opens your mind up to receive these insights. It allows you to open up to the possibility of this goal being manifested. Most of us are not able to manifest things because we don't believe it. Our attitude, our dominant attitude and vibration is not changing. One effective way to do that is through visualization. Keep? Yes. Yes.
About this dream making.
Mm-hmm. About?
Dream making.
Yes.
There is story.
Mm-hmm.
And a script writer.
Yes.
Like he makes a story so that they can pictureize it accordingly.
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
Because something in story you read, it sounds there, but in picturization, you can't picturize that.
Yeah, you can't recreate it exactly the way you first thought about it.
Yeah.
I guess that's what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
Well, that is.
Not
exactly the way you actually thought of it. Well, that's true. That's exactly why we come to the third part of the session, which is how to effectively visualize. You have a good idea and a thought, right, of you having perfect health now. But what happens when you're not able to create the right pictures for perfect health, right? What if I need a lot of money and I want to have a lot of money, but you see, not clear thoughts of me having that money is coming to my mind, right? These are some challenges and constraints. So we will come to that part, which is yes. 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 Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Second stage,
yes.
We can go ahead faster.
Yes.
So
and we will
visualize that we are doing it regularly.
Yes.
So that it will help us to overcome.
Yes. Basically, you have to create like a movie, but in this case, it has to be a short movie. It doesn't have to be a 3-hour movie. It doesn't even have to be 15-20 minutes movie. It can be as short as couple of minutes at a time. Okay? And all your questions will be answered as we are coming to the next points now. Okay? First of all, the answer to can I visualize this is always yes. You can visualize anything, no matter what, whether it is you waking up early in the morning, it is spending good enough for amount of time with your family, you making a lot of money, you recovering from an illness. Answer to all of this is yes, because it's your mind. You see, have you seen Miracle on 34th Street, the very famous movie Miracle on 34th Street? Well, there's a scene in the movie, okay, where this little girl is in front of Santa Claus, and Santa is giving gifts to all, and she seems sad. So he says, oh, you don't like my gift? And she says, no, what I want is, this is not what I want. I want something else. So Santa says, what is stopping you? Go get it. And then she's looking at him and saying, I don't know how to get it. And he says, you don't know? You don't know you have a gift? And she says, what gift do I have? And he says, you have a gift called imagination. And then he explains to this little girl, imagination, she's a little girl, so he explains to her properly, imagination is like any other nation. Just as you have an Indian nation, you have a French nation, you have a British nation, same way we have something called as an imagination. The best part about this place, he tells her, is you need no tickets, no visas. Stay there for as long as you want, it's up to you. The best part is you don't need anybody's permission to go wherever you want to go. This is purely you in control. So the concept really is that yes, we can imagine whatever we want. So you never ever have to ask someone, can I visualize this? Always the answer is going to be an affirmative yes. No matter what you want, you can visualize it because it is your mind. And you have every right to give your subconscious mind a command, a direction for you to experience and manifest anything you want. Okay? So after today, your job is just to create a story. Don't waste time thinking, is this possible or not? Okay? You have to start with the point that this is what I want. Your job is just to feed your mind with these thoughts and images. Before we begin with, you know, other points like how much time, how many times in a day, and how do we do it, the first prerequisite, I think, is sitting in silence. Okay, so today, for example, if you're going to go home and create a proper story, you know, you have to decide what are you going to visualize about, what are the scenes, right? You have to spend some time doing this exercise in terms of preparation, right? Then visualizing will not be difficult. You need to have some preparation time for this. Most people will just close their eyes and start. This is the problem. You have to first spend some time connecting with yourself, and therefore really sitting in silence is very important. So today when you go home, or if today you want to take a break after this session and tomorrow you want to do this exercise, is also fine. But make sure you sit with yourself for at least 15 minutes. Okay, focus on your breathing, connect with yourself. Ask yourself this question, what is it that I really want? I'm telling you why this is important, because most people are confused. I get questions like, what should I visualize first? I want money also, I want good health also, I want this also, and I want that also. Where do I start? You see, we are totally confused. And so the first step to have clear visualization is first figure out what your priority is. One way to find out is sitting in silence with yourself. Ask yourself, what is it that I really want right now in my life? Answers will come. You know why? Because that little child inside of you, your deeper mind, is waiting for you to talk. It's almost like it was waiting, and it's exhausted now. That I am not getting any time to reveal what I want. Right? So spend time. If it doesn't come in one sitting, it's okay. Continue to sit for the next few days. You will get a clear picture. Most of the times we will get a clear picture. A clear picture could be, you know, a health challenge. A picture could be a relationship. Somebody's face comes in and you feel this is what you want to heal, right? It could be any healing in finances, in health, or in relationships. But you will get some pictures. You will hear some voices. You will get some pictures. See, that's your clue. That means this is my number one priority. So start creating a story for visualization around this issue. Because most of the times we fail in visualization because we are not connecting with that story. So this step is very important. Don't miss this step. Once you have prioritized, this is my number one goal, remember, only visualize for this. Don't mix it up with other things. Continue practicing visualization on that one goal. Don't mix it up. In my opinion and in my experience, you mix it up and it doesn't work. Give it one pointed focus. See, this is what we call as a pure thought. What is a pure thought? One pointed focus on a certain issue. That's when all your cells start vibrating with that experience and energy of those pictures. You give it different pictures, you're confused. There have been times when I've had my clients tell me, you know, I'm visualizing on three goals, one morning, one afternoon, one night, and then they get confused. Morning kya visualize kiya, raat ko kya visualize kiya, afternoon ko kya kiya, they forget. Confusion, confusion, confusion. Solution is, go with one at a time. One at a time. You will be amazed at the power you have to manifest when this materializes. After that, go for something else. It's all yours. It's your mind. There's no limit to what you can imagine and how much you can imagine. But please go one at a time. Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
Suppose we prioritize our goal.
Yeah.
We are working towards it. Mm-hmm. In the meantime, something else comes up unexpectedly. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Which is also very important.
Yes.
We can't avoid that.
No.
We have to focus on that also.
Yes.
To handle the problem.
Yes.
How do we do one thing at a time?
Yeah.
Something else crops up. Mm-hmm. Unexpectedly.
Yes.
And equally important to handle.
Yes. So when something comes up unexpectedly, generally when I'm already doing self work, inner work like visualization, I'm better equipped to handle the situation. If you're really doing visualization correctly, you should be in a few days far more controlled than you initially were. So even though I'm taking one goal to visualize, actually all other areas are benefiting because it's my one energy, na? See, I'm an energy being. Any goal I'm using, I'm only using that goal as a starting point. As a starting point to channelize my efforts in a direction that my subconscious mind really wants to achieve. That's all. But once I'm using that goal as a direction, automatically my energy and vibration goes up. Supposing I have an urgent meeting. Supposing, you know, I have a deadline tomorrow. I can definitely visualize about it that night before I sleep and I can go with confidence for that meeting. So yes, when it comes to the short-term challenges, you can always use your mind to visualize. But here we are talking about a consistent image which is for a long-term goal, which is for a goal which you will always want, like good health, like money, like relationships, right? So yes, there would be times when you have something urgent coming up. You can spend a few minutes visualizing a happy outcome, a successful outcome. And once that event is over, you can stop. Rest of the times, please keep your topmost priorities in mind, which means have a goal list and go to one goal at a time. Again, I'm repeating, you are using your visualization technique for one goal. But what is happening is overall energy and vibration is going up. Your confidence in other areas are automatically going up. This is how visualization works. You just have to first pick out an area that you're very emotional about, which is what should come up in your silent sitting. Something you're very, very emotional about. We just want to catch that emotional connect. Once you have your emotional point very clear and you start visualizing, your chances of it manifesting are very, very high. Okay, so shall we now go to the next point? So firstly, you must meditate. If you don't like the word meditation, it's okay. Some people don't like the word meditation. So silent sitting, sitting with yourself, figuring out what your priority is right now and start creating a story on it, which means a real story. What is a story? What?
My goal.
Your goal. Description of your goal, if I may add. Please describe your goal as already accomplished. As all of you already said, it's about feeding thoughts of a happy outcome. Okay, so a very simple question. If you want to lose weight, are you going to see yourself eating healthy food daily, or are you going to see yourself as fit, slim, fine and flexible? Combination. What are the other thoughts?
Day by day, I'm getting, becoming slimmer.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. What are some other thoughts on this issue?
For becoming slim.
Mm-hmm.
When I visualize that I'm slim.
Mm-hmm.
And enjoy all the facilities. Then
okay.
A slim person can enjoy.
Well. Exactly. Well, if you focus on one day at a time, you will also get results in the same manner, in the same pace, as we can call it. So therefore the focus should always be on how life has changed, how you are living your life now having achieved your goal. Because you see, if you see yourself with healthy food, for example, using it in a combination is a very good idea. I would always see myself eating healthy, jogging, feeling fit and fine. But you see, if I'm only seeing myself doing things that will make me slim, that's not the correct visualization. I have to ultimately see myself slim. I have to see myself doing things that I would do with a perfectly new healthy body. And most people don't do that. Always focus on the realized outcome that you want to achieve. If you keep your focus there, you see, you feel good, right? Now, supposing you're sharing with me a story about, you know, a past success. Okay? You may start with, you know, I had to work so hard and there were so many challenges. But, you know, when I received that promotion, things changed. Automatically, your energy is changed. See, this is the peak of energy that you reach when you talk and think about something which made you very, very happy and proud. So your job now in visualization is clearly describing how life feels with this newly accomplished goal. This is far easier than we think it is. You just have to sit down and describe how you are feeling and create a good description around it. Sit with a pen and a paper, and this is a one-time exercise for a goal. Okay, figure out all the things. It's almost like you're narrating to your best friend. You're narrating this story to someone that, you know, how good you feel that today you enjoy financial freedom and you can do what you want. How you have healed your finances with your mind. How you have attracted the right opportunities and how today your family and you are so secure financially. How you are not worried about where the money is coming from. The money just continues to flow. It feels relieving. It feels happy. It's almost like I feel I'm on top of the world. I'm describing in words, through expressions of emotions, how I would really feel. Imagine on a daily basis, if you are allowing yourself to vibrate with the thought of having achieved this financial success, your brain is going to go to work, because your brain does not know the difference between an activity that you are visualizing in your mind and an activity that you are actually performing. So research studies at Harvard University pointed out that students who visualized performing a task in advance in their mind actually completed the task in reality with almost 100% accuracy. As compared to students who did not visualize, they completed the task in about only 55% accuracy. So clearly, visualization does something. It clearly does something to the brain. It clearly helps the brain achieve much more. It opens you up to new ideas and thoughts, as we already discussed. Okay? So that's your job. On a daily basis, feed it that food. Okay? So you sit in silence, figure out what you want. Second step is write a clear story of how life has changed. This is the story that you are now going to be using as images in your visualization. Okay? So supposing in my visualization I have written about overcoming a health issue. Let's say somebody has overcome an issue of pain in joints and now the person's legs are fine, they're feeling good, they're hale and hearty. Well, how would you describe this in your visualization? Firstly, you would write down very clearly what are all the things you can now do with your legs. With your perfectly healthy body, your hands, your legs, how does it feel to be without this issue? That is your focus and subject of attention in your visualization. In a few lines, always think of somebody very close to you. You're describing your newly achieved life. having achieved this goal with a very close friend. So who is going to describe to me something that they want to manifest as if I am their best friend right now? Who would want to go ahead and do it? Who would like to do it? Somebody would like to do it, I'm sure. So that everybody can benefit, come on. Nobody wants to do it now, you want to do it at home? Don't want to waste even a single moment. No, I'll keep my visualization just for myself. Okay? Yes, in few words, come on, what is it that you would like to manifest in your life?
Reorganize the career.
Yes, reorganize. So imagine it's happened. Tell me, share with me in a few words that it's actually happened. How will you share it with me?
Hasn't happened. I'm trying to visualize it.
No, don't visualize it. Create first a story. The reason why we are not able to visualize it, because we are not creating a story in words first. You have to first write it in words. Once you write it in words, it's all out on paper. It means you have conceived the idea. Once you have conceived the idea, now visualization will become easier. You understood how we are missing an important step? We are missing an important step. So therefore, I am focusing. And the reason why I asked you this is because we have issues narrating what we want. All of us. It's not very clear in our minds. Although we really want it.
Fragmented.
It's not an organized thought. Let's put it that way. And trust me, friends, for visualization to work, you need to have organized thoughts. It's almost like if I wake up with my left leg on the floor every day, visualization is like that. See yourself in the same clothes. See yourself doing the same activities. See yourself around the same people, then visualization becomes real. Now for that, you need to first write a story. So for example, if I'm working on my health and I'm visualizing, you know, myself in perfect health, my story could be somewhat like, these days when I wake up in the morning, I am so energetic. My grandchild comes and tells me, you know, you look awesome, you look so fresh. I'm so happy that now you can play cricket with me. Very short, sweet, simple, but I'm stressing on how I have improved physically. Energy, vitality, good health is coming to me and it's becoming more believable through a story. So first you have to write a story. First, think of what is exactly going to happen if you have achieved the goal. Conceive the thought first in your mind, put it down on a piece of paper. Read it a few times. Automatically, images pertaining to that are going to come to your mind. It's a step-by-step process. You don't have to be a pro from day one. It's a gradual process. You see, very few people will come back and tell me, oh, I am fantastic in visualization. Because most of us have been accustomed to visualizing what we fear by default. You start imagining things. Notice, phone ringing maybe at midnight, we are already imagining what is wrong, somebody is not well, some bad news coming to me. You see, we are so quick at doing it because we are conditioned. We are trying to change that. We are saying now conceive a good thought. Organize the thought in the form of a story. This story is about your goal having been accomplished. You've received the 10 crores that you wanted. Now, I am working with people I always wanted to work. I have now my hands on projects which are very, very rewarding to me. I am now doing the work I always wanted. I wanted to teach. And now having received so much money, I am teaching all over the world. That's a story. So now when I visualize, I can see myself, you know, in a huge office, giving high fives to people in the morning, saying, oh, amazing, that's a good deal. I can see myself talking and, you know, speaking to people in the teaching profession. You see, once I've created a story, visualization will automatically come. The problem is we are trying to force pictures without a story. Okay? Create a story today, tomorrow, whenever you get the time. Once your story is ready, take time, take 2 days, 3 days to prepare your story. No hurry. Once story ready, immediately close your eyes and try to read the story almost like now you're mentally reading it. Keep the paper in front of you. If you get stuck, read it again, close your eyes and visualize the same story. So, your story must have a sequence. your story should have a sequence. What is the sequence? There has to be a starting, there has to be a middle point, there has to be an ending. Keep it short. How much time do you think you need to visualize at a time? Not more than 2 minutes. Not more than 2 minutes. Research studies tell us that if you visualize for longer time, you will start getting counter intentions. Your brain begins to catch the lie, which is it's not happening yet. You will start feeling negative about that very experience. We don't want to give an opportunity for you to feel like that. So keep it minimal. 1.5 to 2 minutes at a time is enough. Now you can do this 3 times in a day. 3 times in a day, and within 10 minutes you would have visualized everything, even if you want to go longer. Not more than 10 minutes, even after you're doing it 3 times in a day. Keep it short, but keep it clear. You see, clear, well-defined, repeated images will bring you success. Clear, well-defined, and repeated images. Don't change the image. If your starting of your story is that you're waking up in the morning with your arms like that saying, today is a beautiful day, and you're hugging somebody close to you and saying, I feel so good, then that's your starting point. Don't change it. If you end your day with your best friend telling you, give us some tips, what do you do? Share some tips with us also. We also want to be so energetic like you. If that's your last point of the story, always end like that until you are living this very reality of a perfectly healthy body. Yes. Now the reason why I'm saying it is, if you look at, for example, a movie, most of the times you come back remembering what about the movie? Dialogues? Most of us have our favorite dialogues from movies as well, right? It helps you establish an emotional connect. What is a movie without emotions? Nothing, right? So including dialogues in your visualization makes it very real, because after all, we are constantly interacting with the outside world. So my point is, do everything that you can, including dialogues, sounds, into your visualization.
That will create
an emotional connect. Because most of the times, you will always measure your performance basis what somebody else tells you. Well, even if you're feeling very good, and somebody comes and tells you, kya ho gaya aapko, itne patle ho gaye ho aap, weight kam hota ja raha hai, sab theek to hai, and you feel something is wrong with me. Something is wrong with me. You come and tell your husband or wife at home, kuch to, I told you, no, meko lag raha hai, kuch to galat hai. So clearly, yes, these things affect us. But you see, involve people in your visualization who are very close to you, right? Who matter to you. Involve loved ones. Involve people you connect emotionally with very well. Please don't involve your enemies. Let them be happy where they are. Bless them. But not in your story. Okay, this is your story for your life, for your goal. Visualize people you will share your success with, whether it's a financial success, a healing in a relationship, or healing in your own physical body, right? So try and involve a conversation, almost like a movie running, that will make it very believable for the subconscious mind. And what is a movie without sounds, after all? How boring would the movie be with no music, right? So involve dialogues. Who's talking to you? Who's looking at you? Where are you? Is it your home? Are you outside? Are you in a party? Are you receiving an award at an award function? Then which stage is it? What does the stage look like? Right? Your speech after having received the award. Sharing about, you know, how beautiful, you know, everything seems today because your hard work has finally paid off. You're thanking everybody in the crowd, and especially your family. You know, that can be a good visualization, right? So dialogues and sounds are important, okay? It should be a part of your story. My third point, but it's very important. Although it's third in sequence, it's topmost for me. Please do not visualize when you are angry or upset. Do not visualize when you are in a bad mood. Why? Do you ever eat well when you are irritated or upset? Should you eat when you are irritated or upset, by the way?
No.
You shouldn't. Why? Because all the energy is going inside. It's the same with visualization. Don't attempt it when you are irritated, in a bad mood. It's almost like, you know, you're having a fight with someone and say, I hate you, get lost. Now I'm visualizing. Go, go, you go away, get out. Let me visualize. It doesn't work like that. Right? You have to be in a good vibration. So, my recommendation is, always identify how you are feeling before you visualize. And supposing I feel low on energy, supposing I just feel nothing is working for me, supposing I'm tired, I'm irritated, simply recall a very happy moment from your life. It could be the face of your grandchild, it could be the face of your children, it could be a conversation, it could be a situation where you received a lot of praise and appreciation and love. Think of it for a few seconds and you would have raised your vibration. Just a few seconds. Remind yourself of some very happy, memorable moment and then close your eyes and start visualizing. Again, keep it short. So this is how it is. You have to raise your vibration and your energy before you visualize. You have to feel good. Otherwise, you're actually simply wasting your time. It's not going to work anyways. Okay? Now, one little tip. While you are at the peak of the story in your visualization, sometimes some of us may get some counter thoughts.
That happens.
Yes, so you must keep yourself busy with an affirmation. For example, I really deserve this. I really deserve this. Or whatever is the subject of your visualization. For example, if I'm visualizing for good health, I could simply affirm a few times before I open my eyes. I'm enjoying perfect health. I'm enjoying great financial success and freedom. I am enjoying healthy and beautiful relationships. Whatever is the subject of your visualization, create a positive suggestion around it. Now, when will you repeat the suggestion? The best time to repeat the suggestion is almost towards the end of the story. And once the story is over, don't immediately open your eyes. Because manifestation is never in the thoughts. It's always in the gap between the thoughts. So before you open your eyes, close your eyes. And how do you counter intentions? Affirm this very statement which summarizes the essence of your story. Whether it's health, it's relationships or success. Just affirm, I am enjoying success in this area. Say this for at least 11 to 14 times with some nice deep breaths. And then open your eyes. This is one of the most effective ways to visualize clearly. Okay? This is simple but very, very powerful technique involved in visualizing effectively. Okay? You can use the affirmation as a way to convince your mind that this has already happened. I am now enjoying. And secondly, it's almost like repetition is the mother of learning. So anything that you repeat on a consistent basis, the subconscious takes it as true. Okay, do you have any question on visualization? Well, that's all I could cover for the session. It's a huge topic. There are several techniques. If you want to learn, you must know this is a topic which can go in depth. I personally, I'm usually satisfied taking 2 days because there are so many techniques, so many methods of visualizing, short visualizations, quick visualizations pertaining to health, finances and relationships. So, if this resonates with you, start off with these points I have given you and then you can always go deeper with your coach. Okay? Just 3 tips. Today, I'm going to leave you with 3 tips. Okay? No matter what we want to achieve in life, just 3 tips I would want to leave you with. First, please daily acknowledge your power. Your power. Daily tell yourself that I am powerful. You see, so many people have achieved big things because they never laughed at their own thoughts and ideas. So please don't underestimate yourself. Acknowledge your power daily. The second tip I want to leave you with, really tips, but they are really almost like suggestions for us to lead better lives. Second one is, please invest in your passion. Don't wait, I'm going to reach so many years and then I will do what I really want. Success lies exactly where your passion is. So if you're passionate about something, you can visualize it now. And resources and help opportunities must come. Don't ignore your passions. And the third has to be one of my favorites. Please forgive everybody. Because if you hate someone more than you love someone, your dominant attitude, personality, vibration is hate. And that is going to affect your success. Even if you achieve success, you will have a fall like this. Forgiveness is crucial to our overall well-being. Bless others daily. That's it from me for now. Until we meet again, wishing you all the very best. Namaste. Thank you. Thank you.